about NetTraining.net. ASP. Net is a part of the Net framework. It builds services required to create web applications with minimum coding. This coding can be done in any language that is compatible with standard language runtime. Visual Basic and C languages are compatible to ASP.NET and help you to benefit from common language runtime. ASP.NET is an open source framework which is designed to create web pages. Microsoft develops this open source. In this course, you will learn all you need to begin your journey to become a .NET developer. This course is for those who aspire to be IT professional or who want to move from other domains to .NET. Course overview. Our .NET training courses are instructor-led and can be taken in a classroom or live online. It delivers a full series of .NET training courses. Our .NET training lineup includes courses that cover fundamentals through advanced topics and provide high-end quality online training courses. This online course helps you to understand the concepts and different levels of web application using ASP.NET. Our teaching methodology will help you to prepare for the interview, and the project work helps you to face real-world projects. Any beginner can take this course and eventually grow as a developer. This curriculum designed for beginners and professionals. Prerequisite. Any person who wants to learn .NET should have prior knowledge of HTML and C#, basic understanding of ASP.NET web form is recommended. Apart from these link, entity framework and SQL Server for database-related operations knowledge is preferred. However, we will take the basics and help the learner to feel comfortable with .NET. List of course syllabus covered in this .NET training are Introduction to Web Programming. In this module, you will learn about how the browser and server gets communicating with each other, life cycle of HTTP, about the HTTP protocol and also the importance of GET and POST methods. Communication between web server and web browser. HTTP protocol. HTTP request life cycle. Request and response structure via about GET and POST methods. Overview of HTML and JavaScript. In this module, you will learn about the basics of HTML, JavaScript language and the document object model, handling events in JavaScript, steps for debugging JavaScript, performing client-side validations and alter, show, hide and move objects on a web page. HTML overview. HTML tags reference. HTML examples. Introduction to JavaScript. JavaScript examples. Debugging JavaScript in versus.NET. Overview of classic ASP. In this module, you will learn about the how HTML page is displayed on the web server, how ASP page is rendered on the web server, ASP objects, installing IS and ASP on Windows and HTML form behavior. ASP object. Understanding form tag. Request and response model. Overview of ASP.NET web forms. In this module, you will learn about how an application can be built ASP.NET web forms, ASP.NET architecture, and ASP.NET web forms controls, page events in page life cycle, navigation, and master page. Creating an ASP.NET website. Using ASP.NET web form controls. ASP.NET architecture. Understanding page controller v architecture. Navigating between pages. Overview of master pages. Introducing to ASP.NET MVC. In this module, you will learn about the significant pieces of the Microsoft ASP.NET MVC framework, responsibilities of model, view, and controller, benefits of MVC design over traditional ASP.NET web forms. What is MVC architecture? What is ASP.NET MVC? Understanding model. Understanding view. Understanding controller. Advantages of MVC-based web application. Features of ASP. Net MVC Framework. First MVC Application. In this module, you will learn about the MVC folder structure, how to create a new ASP. Net MVC project, role of model, view, and controller in integrating them to develop a complete web application and request life cycle. Software requirements. Developing first MVC applications. Rendering HTML output. Understanding life cycle of ASP. MVC request. Exploring controller's. In this module, you will learn about the passing data from the controller to view, action methods of controller class, action result object returns form action methods, action filters, and asynchronous controllers. Exploring controllers and controller base class. Exploring Razor views. In this module, you will gain inputs about the Razor syntax fundamentals, advantages of Razor syntax over traditional ASPX markup syntax, layout view, implementing the sections in view, partial views and types of views. Introducing Razor view. Razor syntax fundamentals. Enum support. Layout view Razor, master pages. The significance of view start.cshtml. Working with sections. Working with partial views. Bootstrap support for editor templates. Digging into HTML helpers. In this module, you will learn about what are HTML helper methods, how to use them in Razor syntax, how to use for methods with strongly typed models, overriding the display and editor templates and building custom helpers using extension methods. HTML helper methods. Render HTML form. Using drop-down list. Binding HTML helper to model. Using for methods with typed model. Overriding display templates. Overriding editor templates. Custom helper method. Understanding model binders. In this module, you will learn about the default model binders and building custom model binders for typical conditions in which built-in default binders are not usable. Default model binder. Complex type model binding. Form collection model binding. HTTP posted file model binding. Bind attribute. Annotations and validations. In this module, you will learn about how to implement data annotation, applying validation framework for both client and server validations, how to build custom validations and to develop custom unobtrusive client-side validation. Overview of data annotations. Annotations and validation attributes. How validation works. Explicit server-side validations of models. Custom validations using valid data table object. Developing custom unobtrusive client-side validation. Applying annotations to model classes using metadata class. Web configuration file and global application class. In this module, you will learn about the architecture of a config file, app settings, HTTP application class, limitation of exception handling, how to catch a specific type of errors and how to encrypting connection string. Architecture of config file. Machine.config and web.config. App settings. System. Web section. Exception handling. Location section. Encrypting connection string. State management techniques. In this module, you will learn about data sharing across same client, user requests using cookies and session management. Cookies. Managing cookies in ASP. Net MVC application. Authentication in cookies. Cookie dictionary. Sessions management. Sharing data between clients using static class. Web caching. In this module, you will learn about the output caching and data caching. Output cache. Implement data caching using object cache and memory cache. CRUD operations using entity framework. In this module, you will learn about the CRUD operations using link and entity framework, repository patterns, generic repository and understanding about dependency injection. Basic CRUD operations using scaffold templates. Separation of work using BOC classes. Using single database context object across all business objects v. writing generic class, repository. Caching in repository. Custom controller factory and dependency injection. Authentication and authorization. In this module, you will learn about the types of authentication, how to use Windows authentication, how to use forms authentication, encrypting the password in a config file and role-based authentication. Overview of authentication and authorization. Types of authentication, authorize, and allow anonymous, attributes. Windows authentication implementation. Forms authentication implementation. ASP. Net identities. In this module, you will learn about the single sign-on using Facebook and Google, two-factor authentication, email confirmation, and role management. ASP. Net identity introduction. Owen and Kate Anna. Customizing template generated code. Extending identity model and using integer key instead of string key. Auth and social authentication. Code MVC application with Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn and Google OAuth to sign on. Implementing email confirmation. Two-factor authentication. User and role management. URL routing. In this module, you will learn about the mapping URL to controller action method, applying constraints and attribute routing in MVC 5. Overview. Mapping URL to controller action method. Applying constraints on route parameters. Resolving namespace ambiguity ignoring routes. Attribute routing improvements in MVC 5. Working with areas. In this module, you will gain knowledge about the concept of areas, how to add an area for MVC project, linking between areas. Understanding areas. Adding areas. Registering areas. Linking between areas. AJAX and jQuery. In this module, you will learn about the AJAX helper methods, how to use jQuery UI controls and jQuery templates. AJAX implementation using jQuery. Using AJAX. Begin form helper method. jQuery UI controls. jQuery templates. Bundling and minification. In this module, you will learn how to optimize the CSS and .js files using bundling and minification features, using wildcard to select files and using CDN feature while bundling. Why bundling and minification? What is bundling? What is minification? Impact of bundling and minification. Implementing bundling and minification. Creating and using bundles. Using wildcard to select files. Using a CDN while bundling. Mobile compatibility. In this module, you will learn about the mobile compatible views, how to customize the display modes and overriding the display modes. Built-in support for display modes. Adding custom display modes. Overriding display modes. RESTful services using ASP. Net Web API. In this module, you will learn about the RESTful services, calling the web API with JavaScript and jQuery HTTP response message and IP action result and creating a web API that supports GRUD operations using F. Introduction to REST protocol. Web API routing. Developing sample application. Creating a web API that supports GRUD operations using F. Calling web API service methods from JavaScript, jQuery, TDD and debugging a web application. In this module, you get knowledge about the test-driven development cycle, how to use mock framework. Create and run unit tests. Create mocks. Create and run web tests, including using browser link. Multi-layered architecture demo app. In this module, you will learn about the creating reusable and flexible application using multi-layered architecture. Real-time project involving most of the above concepts with following will be provided. Product abstract document. Requirement specification document. Step-by-step procedure for building the project from ground up. Complete source code. Database script with sample data. Instructions to set up the project on a development box. Instruction to deploy the project to production box, Microsoft Azure .NET certification. After successful completion of this course and project work, certificate in ASP.NET will be awarded by the training provider. This certification will help you to get good jobs, .NET jobs and placement. With ASP.NET certification, a person becomes software professional and a developer. He can get jobs to the best of the companies like Microsoft, IBM, etc. Why should you take this .NET training course? .NET very much ubiquitous in many software development companies due to its low cost of development. It is open source and easy to learn for any developer. .NET has access to .NET framework which extends Windows API for every developer. It is easy to execute, debug and create applications in .NET and all the functions can be performed in a single environment. Use of Visual Basic Language, which fully supports SUPS. You will have a better understanding of MVC architecture. Build forms with server-side and client-side validation. Implement authentication and authorization using ASP.NET MVC. Build RESTful services using ASP.NET Web API. Use powerful jQuery plugins. You will have a better understanding of multi-layered architecture and repository pattern. You will have a better understanding of dependency injection. You will be able to test the application using unit testing. You will have a better understanding of a mock framework. You will be able to deploy the application in web server, Azure.